What the? Slackers.
Once again, and welcome to another episode of Humpteenth Time Hearing. I'm Bill, bringing you yet another song from the collection of obscure ones that are just rattling around in the back of my brain. Generally obscure songs from generally obscure artists, not always, and generally from about the 1980s, give or take a little bit sometimes. Songs that I know like the back of my hand, but hoping that my umpteenth time hearing might be your first time hearing. And today, I have an artist for the first time from the country of Wales, and that is The Alarm. And the song we're going to be hearing is called The Stand. Now, this is a group I definitely remember discovering during my college DJ years. There were always just great comments written on the covers of the albums about the high energy sound of the band. That was definitely true of The Stand. Another one I remember listening to and playing probably more than I should have was Spirit of 76, another great song of theirs. Now, undoubtedly a factor in their high energy sound was that vocalist and founding member Mike Peters started the band in 1977 as The Toilets, a punk rock band. And it was over a few years with numerous band member changes, not numerous, but a few band member changes and name changes, that in 1981, they settled on The Alarm with an arena rock type of sound. And obviously it really worked for them because just a couple years later, they had a real banner year in 1983. Not only were they opening for U2, which, of course, is just a phenomenal exposure. Now, this was the year before Pride in the Name of Love was released in the United States, or was released in general, and became their breakthrough single in the United States. But they were already quite well known in England and Europe, and so that level of exposure was a great step forward for The Alarm. And then also in 1983, they released their eponymous EP, a five-song release, of which The Stand was the first song on that EP. And this then led to signing with, I believe it was IRS Records, for their debut album in 1984, Declaration. And from that through 1991's Raw, they released a total of five albums total. Broke up, and then in late 1990s, and started recording in the 2000s, Mike Peters reformed The Alarm as The Alarm, capital M, capital S, plus sign, MM plus plus, to indicate the year 2000 onwards. It was a slightly different version of The Alarm, of course, with different rotating band members based on who was working on what projects, and often included band members from other well-known alternative acts of the era, such as The Cult and Gene Loves Jezebel. And so they've been doing this kind of thing for decades. And I don't want to keep you waiting any further, but since they have been so active, they do actually have a really fantastic webpage of their own. Some of these other artists I've done, they haven't been active so long, not so much information. The Alarm, much more so. Their webpage is included in the top pinned comment below, along with the song lyrics. As always, I encourage you to check those out, because Mike Peters, not always the easiest to understand. But I don't want to keep you from it any longer. So before we go any further, let's just get right into the music as always, playing start to finish without interruption so you can enjoy it for your first time perhaps hearing this. This is The Alarm with The Stand. Enjoy.
Stand. wore that cowboy boots, and he walked like no man on earth. That's where he had no net.
And there you have it, folks. A great live televised performance from 1983, which, of course, sounds different from the studio release that I heard back in the college days. But I think that video is just a great way of showcasing the high energy that they had gave to their performances. It's like they're committed to every song as if it was their last one. And their sound was like that all the way through. Now, in case you didn't pick up on it from reading the lyrics or listening to the song, this is something I noticed, I think, a bit when I was in college, but of course, no Wikipedia back then. But the Alarms song, The Stand, is based on the Stephen King novel, The Stand. If you look through and talk about The Walking Man and Swear He Had No Name, all that, if you know the Stephen King work or either of those two miniseries that they made from it, you know exactly what I'm talking about here. Now, this is, I gotta say, and I'm a big Stephen King fan, but I don't know of any other song of Stephen King's, or I'm sorry, song of Stephen King's, any other novel of Stephen King's that's been adapted into a song. And for that matter, I can't think off the top of my head, and I've thought about it more than just off the top of my head, actually, of any other novel that's been adapted into a song. Now, perhaps, Heathcliff, Wuthering Heights by Kate Bush. Okay, yep, if you want to go, there's one of the classics, but in terms of modern novels, certainly no horror novels that I know of. So, any thoughts on those? Any others besides Wuthering Heights and The Stand that you can think of? Pop those into the comments down below. Speaking of those comments, as I mentioned, the Alarm has a really great active page right now. There's, you know, Mike Peters is still touring with different members, and they, in fact, have a 40th anniversary two-night show at Gramercy Theater in New York City on June 23rd and 24th. So if you've been a fan of The Alarm or you like that sound and you want to head to New York City, there's a great chance to catch them. There's other tour dates and all kinds of information on their webpage, so do check that out in the top pinned comments. Those lyrics are there if you didn't get them the first time through. As always, if you're new to the channel, please do click that subscribe button. I'm bringing out a new piece of music every week just to see if it's something new and different for you, an artist you might be interested in pursuing more, or maybe remind you of a song from back in the day. So don't forget that subscribe button, click that notifications bell, appreciate any likes that you want to click on, and certainly let me know what you think of the program, the artist, or any thoughts or ideas you have about songs that are taken from novels. Now, The Stand is a song taken from the written word, and next week, I'm going to be featuring an artist that in and of itself was taken from pen and paper. I don't want to give away too much here, but even though the artist is fictitious and existed only in the form of drawings, and I don't want to say, well, what form of drawings, but they only existed fictitiously, and yet there was a single released, and it's a great couple of songs for you. So for now, though, as always, thank you so much for watching. Do appreciate folks tuning in. And don't forget, may the best of your past be the worst of your future. Thank you once again for tuning in. Have yourselves a great day. Bye now.